Now we have to discuss the collisions. Collisions are actually short duration interaction between the bodies when they come in contact. For example, suppose two balls on a horizontal surface A and B. This ball A is moving with velocity v1 and B is moving with velocity v2 as shown in the figure. Mass of ball A is m1 and mass of ball B is m2. For these balls to come in contact and causing the collision, first of the condition is that v1 is greater than v2. Ball A is having the higher speed, only then will make a collision. As v1 is higher than the v2, A come closer to B as the time passes, and ultimately A come in contact with B. And when they come in contact, deformation of balls occur. Because of this deformation, velocity v1, that is the velocity of ball A, start to decrease, and velocity of ball B, that is v2, start to increase. And at the maximum deformation, there will be a condition when velocity and ball A and velocity of ball B becomes equal, and in this situation kinetic energy of the balls will be minimum. That means this is stored as a potential energy in the system. After this maximum deformation, these balls start to gain their shapes, and due to this, after the situation of equal velocities, velocity v1 reduces and velocity v2 increases, and because of that, after collision, the separation between them start to increase. This is the basic logic behind the collisions. Now we take the type of the collisions. One is the elastic collision, which we will discuss here. Another is inelastic collisions. These are the two main type of the collisions. And third one is semi-elastic collisions. So first we will discuss the elastic collision. In elastic collision, we have to remember that momentum, that is a linear momentum, remains constant at all time instant. That means if this is a ball A and this is the ball B, ball A is moving with velocity v1, ball B is moving velocity v2, and they make a collision, that is come in contact, and after the collision, ball A moves with velocity v1 dash, this is the ball A, and ball B moves with velocity v2 dash. Mass of ball A is m1 and ball B is m2. So as per the first point, we can say momentum remains constant at all time instants, that is at a start momentum is m1 v1 plus m2 v2. This is the total momentum of the system of these two balls, and this will be equal to m1 v1 dash plus m2 v2 dash. Here we are writing this without using any vector sign because it is the one dimensional motion or the rectilinear motion. It means it is a head-on collision. Head-on collision means the balls are moving on a straight line before the collision and after the collisions. In this situation, we do not require to use the vector sign. But if we are using the oblique collision in which ball can move in a plane, then we have to use the vector form, and we have to resolve and write the momentum equations for the x and the y axis separately. That we will do later. For this one dimensional or the head-on collisions, we are writing this momentum conservation is the equation number one. So momentum remains constant for each and every instant of the collision, before collision, after collision, and in between. Second, we are saying that kinetic energy of the system means the system of these two balls A and B, kinetic energy of the system is not constant, but kinetic energy initial, that means before collision, will equal to kinetic energy final. Final means after collision. It means total kinetic energy of the balls or the system before the collision is half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. This is the kinetic energy before the collision. Now when they come in contact and deformation start to occur, in that situation kinetic energy converts into the elastic potential energy, and it means kinetic energy reduces though total energy of the system remains conserved. Therefore, we are saying that kinetic energy is not constant for throughout the time duration. And after the collision, when the objects overcome from the contact, that elastic potential energy again transferred to the balls in the form of kinetic energy, and after the collision, we will again get the same kinetic energy, that is, it is half m1 v1 dash square plus half m2 v2 dash square. So this is the equation number 2. Here we are saying that kinetic energy before collision equal to kinetic energy after collision, though it is not constant for all time instant. Third, here in elastic collision, balls regains their shapes. That means after collision, there is a deformation in the shapes of the ball, and when the balls overcome from the contact, they regain their shapes and becomes in the original form, and there is no loss of energy, no loss of kinetic energy, and as whole potential energy get converted into the kinetic energy, and we get kinetic energy initial, that is before collision, equal to the kinetic energy after the collision. Therefore, using the equation number 1 and 2, we can write, this is the equation number 1, m1 v1 plus m2 v2 equal to m1 v1 dash plus m2 v2 dash. This implies that m1 into v1 minus v1 dash is equal to m2 v2 dash minus v2. This is our equation number 1. After rearranging the equation. Similarly, we can write the equation number 2, half m1 v1 square minus v1 dash square. We bring these two terms one side and other two terms on the other side, that is half m2 v2 dash square minus v2 square. And now we make factors, this half and half will be cancelled, so it will be m1 v1 minus v1 dash into v1 plus v1 dash, that is equal to m2 v2 dash minus v2 and v2 dash plus v2. This is equation number 4, and we say this is equation number 3. Now dividing equation number 4 by 3, we will get, if we divide equation 4 by 3, it will be m1 v minus v1 dash, v1 minus v1 dash into v1 plus v1 dash divided by m1 v1 minus v1 dash, that is equal to m2 v2 dash minus v2 and v2 dash plus v2 divided by m2 v2 dash minus v2. Now common terms will be cancelled out, this m1 and m1 will be cancelled, v1 minus v1 dash will be cancelled out, similarly m2 will be cancelled out from right side, and v2 dash minus v2 also cancel. So remaining term is v1 plus v1 dash is equal to v2 minus v2 plus v2 dash plus v2. This implies that v1 minus v2, these are the velocities before the collision, equal to v2 dash minus v1 dash. This is the velocity after the collision. We get v1 minus v2 is equal to v2 dash minus v1 dash. The situation is this, there's ball A and ball B having the mass m1 and m2 moving with velocity v1 and v2. After a collision, they start to move with velocities v1 dash, v2 dash. These are the masses m1, m2, and these are the ball AB. This is before collision, and this is after collision. So this v1 minus v2, we can write this is the rate of decreasing the separation. Similarly, v2 dash minus v1 dash, this is the rate of increasing the separation. It is after collision and it is before collision. This is the velocity of approach and this is the velocity of separation. That means v1 minus v2, this is showing the rate at which the balls are coming closer, their separation is reducing, and v2 dash minus v1 dash, they are showing that it is the rate at which the balls are moving far from each other. That means this is the velocity of separation. For elastic collision, velocity of separation after collision will equal to velocity of approach before collision. Here we use a term E, that is the coefficient of restitution. It is the ratio of velocity of separation by velocity of approach. As we have said, velocity of separation is after collision and velocity of approach is before collision. Because before collision, object or bodies or balls have to become closer, and after collision they start to getting separated, and this is equal to 1 for elastic collision because velocity of approach is equal to the velocity of separation. Therefore, we have the equations for the conservation of momentum and for the kinetic energy, in which initial kinetic energy of the system is equal to the kinetic energy after collision. And from these two equations, we get one more equation that is very important from the problem solution point of view, that velocity of approach equal to the velocity of separation in case of the elastic collision. Now we use these equations to find the velocities v1 dash and v2 dash after the collision in terms of the v1 and v2, that is the velocities before collision. So we have equation from the conservation of momentum, that m1 v1 plus m2 v2, this is the momentum before collision, is equal to m1 v1 dash plus m2 v2 dash. This is our equation number 1. It is from the conservation of linear momentum for a collision. Then we have derived one more equation, that is the velocity of separation. Velocity of separation is equal to velocity of approach. It is also equal for the elastic collision. And this velocity of separation is, separation is after collision and approach is before collision. And this is equal to V1 minus V2, and velocity of separation is V2 dash minus V2. Now we have to use these equations to get the V1 dash and V2 dash.